1950, the network of trolleybus routes serving Manchester and Ashton had reached its maximum extent of 44 miles, 17 of which lay outside the Manchester city boundary. The Manchester-owned wiring is shown in red, Ashton Underline in blue, and the SHMD joint board in green. The latter never ran any trolleybuses, whilst Ashton operated the 217, 218 and 219 jointly with Manchester, but never the 216, although it had powers. Opened in stages between 1938 and 1950, the 44-mile network was abandoned between 1955 and 1966. In the mid-30s, the Manchester Transport Committee had been opposed to the introduction of trolleybuses. However, they were outvoted by a powerful pro-coal and electricity lobby within the City Council. Manchester would be served by its trolleybuses for just under 30 years, Ashton for just over 40. Back in 1925, Oldham and Ashton had opened a joint trackless trolley route, but the following year Oldham withdrew, leaving Ashton to work only as far as Hathershaw until February 1939 with 8 single-deckers. Manchester's charismatic general manager Stuart Pilcher definitely did not want trolleybuses. He wanted an all-bus city by the early 40s. However, having lost the argument, it was decided trolleybuses would replace trams on the joint Ashton routes via both Ashton Old Road and Ashton New Road. Despite his opposition to the trolleybus, Pilcher certainly provided Mancunians with a first-rate system, including the purpose-built Rochdale Road depot. The first conversion, Ashton Old Road, took place on the 1st of March 1938, followed by Ashton New Road on the 31st of July. Prior to this, the two operators tested their new double-deckers on the Hathershaw route. Manchester's first 76 vehicles had streamlined bodies similar to those on the buses. These were built by Crossley on frames provided by Metro Camel. 1000 to 1027 rode on Crossley TDD4 chassis. 1028 to 1037 were Leyland TB4s. 1050 to 1061 Crossley TDD6s with 95 horsepower motors. 1062 to 1087 were Leyland TTB4s. On the outbreak of war, plans to convert the Hyde trams were postponed. In 1940 came numbers 1100 to 1136, 37 Leyland TB5s with English electric bodies. These were followed between 1940 and 1943 by all Crossley TDD4s 1137 to 1176. Having started with 8 single-deckers, Ashton would eventually operate 34 double-deckers. The first 7 were 3 Leyland TB4s with English electric bodies. A solitary all-Crossley TDD4, this was their prototype 2-axle trolleybus, and Ashton's only 6-wheelers, a trio of all-Crossley TDD6s. In 1940, a further 8 Crossley TDD4s were allocated various numbers between 50 and 60. This post-war view dates from August 1949. The Crossley code TDD4 stood for trolleybus, double-decker, 4 wheels. Between 1944 and 1946, 6 utility-bodied Sunbeam Ws were added. Subsequent additions will be covered later. Although the intention had been to scrap all Manchester's trams, The war intervened, and the last of the big red cars survived until 1949. These magnificent colour scenes date from the late 30s. After the delayed opening of Manchester's Hyde Road route in January 1950, the network would reach its maximum extent. Next, a few immediate post-war sequences. First, peak hour activity at the end of the extension built to serve the A.V. Rowe factory at Chadderton. Opened in 1943, the last 200 yards or so were actually outside the city boundary. During the long post-war years of rationing and austerity, a pair of Leyland TB5s offload close to Mostyn Cemetery. The boys are mostly wearing the obligatory grey socks, trousers and pullovers, whilst the girls, alighting from 1107, are in hats and coats. Acute shortages of new buses meant Manchester was unable to scrap its last trams until early January 1949. Their full story, together with a range of wonderful footage, is told in our much acclaimed DVD, Trams in and Around Manchester. All but the Hyde Road route would be replaced by buses, and even this was bus operated for 22 months. Despite completing the wiring by 1948, shortage of new trolleybuses delayed the Hyde opening. This finally took place on the 16th of January 1950, and the new 210 trolleybuses were also extended over SHMD-owned wiring from Hyde Market to G Cross. Over the next 3 years, all trolleybus routes were renumbered in the 210 to 219 series. To work the Hyde Road route, 38 all-Crossley Empires with 8-foot-wide bodies and 95 horsepower motors were purchased. Coded as TDD42-1, 1200 to 1237 were delivered between April 1949 and January 1950. Together with 5 built for Ashton, these were the only examples of this type. Built in their Stockport works, the Crossley bodies had distinctive down sweeps to the cab windows and raised lower edges to the 2 rear windows on both decks. To take part in this road safety film, 1230 had been driven out onto the quiet southern section of the Horton Green route, which by 1950 had been renumbered 217. Several retakes were needed before the director was totally satisfied. The crew must certainly have enjoyed this break from their normal routine. A coven of Crossleys, with 1203 on the clockwise wiring layout in Portland Street, which survived until June 1957. 1220 is seen at Hyde Market. Ashton's five empires, 77 to 81, were delivered between December 1949 and March 1950. As there were no other takers, Manchester's 16 Crossley Dominion type TDD 64-1s, numbers 1240 to 1255, were unique. Entering service during 1951 and fitted with 115 horsepower motors, these powerful vehicles were used mostly on part-day duties. The three rear windows on each deck had raised lower edges. From the beginning, all eight-footers had red roofs. Although plans for further extensions had been discussed, these were dropped shortly after coronation year 1953. However, Ashton committed itself to trolleybuses for at least 10 years, whilst Manchester claimed there were no plans to diminish the existing network. It came therefore as something of a surprise when it was announced that owing to the run-down condition of the vehicles and the overhead, the short Moston routes were to be replaced, the 212s going on April the 24th, 1955, and the 211s on August the 7th. Using materials diverted from the Hyde Road conversion as a fuel-saving device, the Moston routes were opened between 1940 and 1943. Outside the peak hours, both main routes terminated some 4 miles from town at the Gardener's Arms, Moston. Working inbound, 1125 clicks through the Frogs leading into Nuthurst Road Loop. Action now near the pub, named after the Lancastrian dialect poet Ben Brierley. This loop was used by a succession of short workings. In Manchester, short turns always displayed the suffix X. Views now on the run into town. In the city, the 211s terminated in Stevenson Square, whilst the 212s and P-car 214s followed a one-way loop through an area of warehouses, offices and workshops. Many buildings seen in these views have long since been demolished. Rochdale Road Garage would continue to provide trolleybuses until the 22nd of April 1956. Some pre-war vehicles did survive the Moston closures, and several of the wartime 1100s lasted another 5 years. The early 1000s would all be withdrawn by January 1956. 1026, still with its original large-style fleet numbers, leaves Edge Lane at the end of the evening rush hour. The three-axle Crossleys rarely appeared in all-day service, mostly being confined to rush hour duties on the old and new roads. When Rochdale Road closed to trolleybuses on the 22nd of April 1956, 1050 was withdrawn. A couple of tickets from the early trolleybus era. One was issued on 1034 and the other on board Crossley 1065 on the 29th of December 1944. The wartime 1100s, which worked on all routes except the 210, would be phased out between 1954 and 1960. Some were replaced by the city's last batch of new trolleys. Delivered between June 1955 and February 1956, 1301 to 1362 were Burlingham-bodied BUT 9612Ts. These chassis, unique to Manchester and Ashton, being assembled at the Crossley Works in Stockport. 1302 caused some controversy when it made test runs on the 211. When local Mostonians complained about their older vehicles, 1302 was swiftly removed. Ashton also purchased 8 identical chassis. Fitted with bodies by S.H. Bond of Withenshaw, they entered service during the autumn of 1956. Their arrival led to withdrawal of number 49, the prototype Crossley TD4 of 1937. Here it is seen shortly before withdrawal, resplendent in the corporation's highly colourful livery. Several 1940 Crossleys, including number 60, were also withdrawn. To save money, 4 of the Sunbeam Ws were rebodied between 1954 and 1958. The first of these, number 64, would enter service in a simplified version of the livery seen here. In the mid-50s, central Manchester played host to a rainbow of company and municipal liveries. Probably the most striking of all was the Ashton combination of red, white and blue. It would be replaced by a less costly peacock blue and cream livery. This unique SHMD Atkinson double-decker would eventually write off trolleybus 1360 in an accident. This was the basic route pattern in force at Piccadilly until the 16th of December 1956. Then, to accommodate a major one-way road scheme, the 210 terminus was relocated across the gardens to load on the south side of Portland Street. Always worked from Hyde Road Garage for the first 6.5 years, the 210s had terminated in George Street, on the opposite side of the Piccadilly Gardens to the old road routes. In the early 50s, the tram tracks were still clearly visible. Inbound 218s and 19s continued to reach Portland Street via A-Town Street until the 15th of June 1957. As from the 16th of June, all trolleybuses terminating in Piccadilly now worked inbound via London Road. Then, after loading on Portland Street, they swung sharp left into A-Town Street. Atmospheric aerial views looking down on Portland Street shortly after introduction of the one-way scheme. On the far left, a complex wiring layout of sidings and loops allowed trolleys to pass those loading at the curb. In the years before the mass advent of the private car, Manchester was literally swarming with buses. Included were the 7 trolleybus services. With a total fleet of 143 vehicles, all but 5 were required for the peak hour turnout. With just 21 vehicles, Ashton now wanted rid of them, Manchester having to remind its smaller neighbour of its earlier commitment to retain trolleybuses until at least 1964. However, Manchester moved swiftly to dispense with its own 213 when it became clear its in-town terminus would disappear beneath a new co-op building. Rather than divert the trolleybuses, the corporation opted for buses. Opened progressively between 1940 and 1948, the 4.5-mile 213 operated totally within the Manchester Council area and served the University District as well as the city football ground. Requiring an average of 14 vehicles, it operated for the last time on the 31st of May, 1959. Inbound vehicles reached the city terminus by way of Swan Street and Miller Street, a short extension opened in July 1948. This was an area scheduled for redevelopment. Here the wiring led from Miller Street to the layover point on Corporation Street. Outbound 213s followed a one-way dogleg using the inner ends of both Rochdale and Oldham Roads. After turning from Oldham Road, they rejoined the double wiring on Great Ancoats Street. South of Ardwick Green, the 213 served the University District. Turning from Oxford Road into Burlington Street. Turning from Burlington Street into Lloyd Street North. It was not until 1946 that the 213s had been extended from the university to Greenhays on the edge of Fallowfield. 9 years later, the crew take their layover at the terminus before setting off on the 25-minute journey back to town. 1335 speeds towards town along Burlington Street. The 217 lasted 20 years. The only route not to penetrate central Manchester, it opened in 2 stages during 1940. Jointly operated, it ran for the last time on the 3rd of July 1960. Action first at Guide Bridge, dividing point between the Ashton and Manchester own wiring. The 217s cautiously negotiated the mass of frogs and crossings, which formed a tight circle also shared with the 219s. The words of an old American train blues lyric, 219 Blues, could apply to Guide Bridge. Oh, the 219 took my baby away, just hope the 217 will bring her back someday. Here the trolleybuses crossed over the former Great Central Manchester-Sheffield line, electrified in 1954. Looking back towards Ashton. This route normally required 9 vehicles. There were few regular short turns, but some 217Xs did terminate at Denton Crown Point. Ashton Road, Denton, looking towards Crown Point and the busy intersection with Hyde Road. The 210s crossed in the background. On leaving Denton, the trolleybuses ran through quieter residential neighbourhoods. The final section included some charming narrow roads. Although the existing trolleybus routes could have been adapted, the 217 was being replaced as part of a plan to provide direct services between central Manchester and an overspill housing estate being built at Horton Green. The Horton Green terminal loop lay on the fringes of the countryside, some of which would later be swallowed up by the new housing. In 1960, it was still possible to watch blue and red trolleys turning in this quiet village backwater. 46 years later, it is possible, through these images, to recapture something of that lost tranquility. Journey time for the 4.5 mile run to Ashton Market, 23 minutes. The two recent conversions, coupled with some reductions in service, allowed Manchester to withdraw its remaining 1100s. This one, 1174, is seen at Denton Crown Point. 1166 was at Toxteth Street and was the last to go in September 1960. Ashton dispensed with 4 veterans, including number 51 of 1940. Their fleet was now down to just 17 vehicles. Manchester still required a daily turnout of 102 trolleybuses. Action at Piccadilly. The The 1200 series Crossleys and the 1300 series BUTs covered all Manchester duties on the remaining five services. 1250 is seen in Manchester weather nearing Piccadilly Station. However, the writing was now very much on the wall. In December 1962, Ashton and the SHMD were told that Manchester intended to complete its conversion programme by 1967. In the interim, overhead maintenance was to be reduced, the BUTs would be given a midlife overhaul, and all the 1200 series would be withdrawn within the next 2 years. Anxious to proceed with the town centre redevelopment, Ashton unsuccessfully demanded immediate replacement of the joint routes. The 210 endured a long gestation, but a short shelf life. Authorised in 1939, it didn't open until 1950, and then only lasted 13 years. From the 20th of January 1963, it was partially taken over by buses, before closing completely on the 28th of April. The closure also spelt the end for the short-lived Crossleys. During 1962, 1242 was hired for a tour of the 9 mile route, stretching from Piccadilly to G Cross, deep in SHMD territory. Normally, the six-wheelers only worked the 210 as far as Denton Crown Point, so it was very unusual to see one venture out this far to G Cross. Standing on the regularly but infrequently used loop at Thornley Park. The following coverage of the 210 from Piccadilly out to Hyde and G Cross was taken by several filmmakers using a variety of film and cameras. As well as covering most duties on the 210, the Empires also appeared on other routes except for Moston and the 216. Turning from A-Town Street into Fairfield Street. Swinging onto London Road, prior to passing under the long railway bridge leading into Piccadilly Station. This junction, one of the busiest on the system, saw a constant procession of trolleybuses on the Hyde Road and Ashton Old Road routes. The Dominions appeared on a variety of Picard duties, including the 212Xs. This former Moston number having been reassigned in 1957 for journeys between A-Town Street and Audenshaw. Note the rare Beardmore taxi. The six-wheelers provided most peak hour and Saturday daytime duties on the 210X to Denton Crown Point. Until 1959, the 213s had crossed at Ardwick Green. This was another good vantage point for filming other operators. Following replacement of the 210, this wiring was retained until June 1965 for journeys to and from Hyde Road Depot. First opened to trolleybuses in early 1940, Hyde Road became the sole trolleybus depot after April 1956. Many duties on the 210 had been worked by buses since January 1963. However, trolleybus drivers were still being recruited. This learner is preparing to make the left turn into Bennett Street. Although rebuilt in 1959, this bridge was still known locally as Fenian's Arch, following an infamous attack on a van carrying Sinn Féin prisoners in 1867. Accessible from both directions, Bellevue Loop came in handy at weekends, when thousands of people from all over the Northwest would arrive to sample the delights of the Bellevue Fun Fair and the zoo. By the early 60s, both horse-drawn carts and trolleybuses were on their way out. Various views now on the long stretch of Hyde Road heading towards Denton. Snaking over the Stockport branch of the Manchester and Ashton Canal at Reddish Bridge. The relatively short 159 was one of several bus routes which acted as feeders to the 210. This loop at Thornley Park was used regularly but infrequently by short workings from town, as well as by vehicles on test runs from Hyde Road Depot. Scenes now on the approaches to the small manufacturing town of Denton. Denton Station. Denton Crown Point would be the limit of operation for the six-wheelers. Next, a rare view of a BUT on the 210, probably substituting for a fail 1200. Looking towards Hyde from Denton. Dropping down to Broomstair Bridge, limit of Manchester's wiring. After crossing the River Tame, passengers would be in Cheshire, travelling under SHMD wires, supported by silver-painted poles. Unfortunately, the joint board's wiring tended to be slacker and less well maintained than elsewhere on the network. Journey time for the 9 miles between G Cross and Piccadilly averaged some 45 minutes. Following closure of the 210, each peak hour, a handful of the big 66-seater Dominions would emerge from Hyde Road. Like all Manchester's six-wheelers, both rear axles were driven. The last examples would be withdrawn in July 1963. A rare view of 1249 at Ashton Market. Fortunately, sister vehicle 1250 has been preserved. A final view of one of Lancashire's last six-wheelers. After a short, somewhat limited lifespan of just 12 years, it was heading back to Hyde Road and the scrapyard. The two-axle Empires did fare a little better, the last of these Stockport-built Crossleys buying out in the October. Although mostly associated with the Hyde Road routes, they had also appeared on the 212 and 219, as well as the 213 and 217 until the mid-50s. These views show Empires on the 219 at the city end of Ashton Old Road. Once dubbed the workshop of the world, Manchester's population had increased rapidly during the 19th century. To escape the grime and dirt of the central area, thousands of terraced houses have been built along or close to the city's principal roads. Ashton had also been reducing its fleet, withdrawing numbers 63 and 64, the two Sunbeams rebodied by S.H. Bond in the mid-50s. Also out were all but one of their empires. Again, they had not lasted very long. These next scenes were appropriately filmed mostly under Ashton wiring. Chester Square was the major junction on the east side of the town. Here the Audenshaw and Guy Bridge routes diverged. Arriving from Guy Bridge, 77 was now under Manchester wires as it negotiates the junction at the Trough. Only one empire now survived, Ashton 80, which for a year was the sole remaining all-Crossley trolleybus in the country. The Manchester fleet now consisted entirely of the Burlingham body BUTs. Most gradually appeared in a simplified livery, omitting the cream round the upper deck windows. Both schemes are seen here at Stephenson Square. On Ashton Old Road, 80 passes Fairfield Road. A peak hour only 212X negotiates the loop. In the spring of 1964, Manchester still required some 70 trolleybuses. The Ashton Old Road services 218 and 219 were jointly worked. Manchester alone covered all duties on the Stephenson Square routes 215 and 216 along Ashton New Road. Audenshaw Ryecroft Hall was a favourite location for filming both corporations. This wiring arrangement, which dated from the late spring of 1959, had replaced a reversing triangle at the nearby Snipe Pub. Ashton Depot, situated about 400 yards from the route to Staley Bridge, on non-revenue wiring, dated from tram days. As there was no physical connection between the internal wiring and the forecourt wiring, this involved lots of depoling and repoling. Having reversed out on its batteries, 80 will have to be repoled before edging out onto Moseley Road. Near St. Michael's Square, Ashton. focal point of this densely populated industrial town with its mills, factories and collieries was the marketplace, overlooked by its imposing market hall, burnt out in 2004 but scheduled to be rebuilt. In the 60s, children could enjoy a ride on one of the roundabouts, whilst the stalls offered a wide range of fresh fruit and veg in the days before the advent of supermarkets and decimalisation. By now, rumour was in the air that the 219 would be the next route to be replaced. On the 5th of July 1964, the National Trolleybus Association organised a tour of the network using number 80, which had fortunately been earmarked for preservation. As with all good enthusiast tours, as much wiring as possible was to be included, especially the little used bits. Running along the former 213 wiring at Higher Ardwick. Undertaking a battery turn at Hyde Road Depot with bamboo pole at the ready. This time, a battery pass in the gathering gloom at Stalybridge bus station. During the 50s and 60s, ever more buildings were demolished for road improvement schemes. As part of the new Mancunian Way, a roundabout, complete with relocated trolleybus overhead, was built on Fairfield Street. On the 28th of July 1964, the trolleybuses began using the new inbound wiring, although the 219 would never use the new outbound wires, which did not come into use until a week after the route closed, with virtually no public warning. The loss of the 7-mile 219 further reduced the number of trolleybuses on Ashton Old Road. The jointly operated 219s paralleled the 218s as far as the trough. This service ran for the last time on the 10th of October 1964, the 3 miles of wiring through Audenshaw and Guidebridge being abandoned. One of the blue Tiger Cubs used on the city circle passes in front of this 219, approaching the loading point outside the Queen's Hotel. An outbound Ashton BUT descends the one-way section along A-Town Street. Fairfield Wells, close to the junction at the trough. Reflecting the interurban nature of the joint routes, Ashton vehicles heading west showed Manchester as the ultimate destination. The turning circle at the trough would be used by short workings until the end of April 1966. Inbound from Ryecroft Hall, a 218X clicks through the junction with the 219. Shortly to be withdrawn were Ashton's two remaining rebodied sunbeams. An outbound 219 takes the wires towards Guide Bridge. On this semi-rural section, the trolleybuses crossed over one railway and under another. This bridge spanned the electrified former Great Central Line, which now terminates at Hadfield. The bridge in the background carried the former London North Western line from Stockport to Ashton Moss Junction. This section linking the Trough to Guide Bridge had opened in October 1939. A slightly damaged sequence showing a pair of BUTs almost at Guide Bridge. Until July 1960, the wiring at Guide Bridge had been shared with the 217s. Here, a short working 219X completes the full circle prior to heading back towards Manchester. A conductor pulls the frog, allowing 80, having passed the Odeon, to use the circle to return to Ashton. Another 219X passes the former railway hotel, now the boundary, before slowly circumnavigating the circle. The 217 wires in Guide Lane having long since been removed. Trolleybuses first began running along this short section of Stockport Road in March 1940, providing a link between Guide Bridge and the existing routes at Chester Square. Following replacement of the 219, the layout at Chester Square was redesigned to include a roundabout in April 1965. This relocation of the overhead would be the last major rewiring work undertaken by Ashton Corporation. Passing the grimy 1870 public baths at Henry Square on the approach to the one-way system through the narrow central area streets. To reach Market Place, the trolleys tackled a couple of right-angled bends. In Bow Street, there was a through wire as well as a siding for vehicles terminating here. 1359 sets off on the 36-minute journey to Piccadilly. Although Ashton 80 survived the 219 closure, it was finally withdrawn during the summer of 1964, thus ending the reign of the All Crossley trolleybus. Some sister vehicles spent time languishing at the side of the depot, awaiting their ultimate fate. In October 1965, Ashton 61 and 62, the pair of wartime Sunbeams rebodied by Roe some 7 years previously, were withdrawn. With no buyers in the offing, they too went for scrap. The market in second-hand trolleybuses had all but dried up. Other Sunbeams had been sold to Bradford, but they never entered service there, being scrapped in 1963. These 61-seaters with their 80-horsepower motors were the last non-BUTs in the Ashton fleet. The first Manchester BUT was withdrawn following an accident in 1962. Then, following closures and service cuts, some 25 were withdrawn during 1964. Amongst them was 1344, today's sole survivor. However, this vehicle would return to Manchester at the very end of 1966. The rundown on Ashton Old Road had started as early as the 20th of July 1964, with buses taking over many Manchester duties. As a result, fewer and fewer red trolleys appeared on the through 218s to Staley Bridge. An excellent view of the wooden troughing carrying the overhead beneath the railway bridge serving Piccadilly Station. Further views of Manchester vehicles working on the through 218. Manchester's presence on the Old Road almost ended altogether on the 30th of April 1966, following introduction of a shorter working week for crews and conversion of the P-car Manchester-only 218Xs between Piccadilly and Audenshaw. However, a few Rush Hour 212Xs continued until the September. This left a handful of Ashton BUTs still working through to Staley Bridge on the 218. Inbound at the junction with the depot only wiring at Pin Mill Brow. Passing the Snipe Inn and looking towards the hills of Longendale. turning towards the marketplace at the west end of the Ashton one-way system. Amongst the chimney pots flanking either side of Stamford Street on the east side of the town centre. Under joint board wiring near Stamford Park. Since 1963, Ashton had assumed responsibility for maintaining the board's last mile of wiring with its distinctive silver-painted poles. Interestingly, this wiring remained in situ months after the final closure, suggesting a dispute over who should remove it. Leaving Stalybridge bus station for the 8-mile, 40-minute journey to Piccadilly. At weekends, an occasional enthusiast special would still take to the wires, such as this BUT looping the loop at Grey Mare Lane. Ashton New Road also suffered a lingering death. Although the 216 remained, for operating and financial purposes, a joint route, both the 215 and 216 were worked exclusively by Manchester Vehicles. The rundown had started with replacement of the country's last all-night trolleybus, the 215X, and the use of buses on Sundays as from the 19th of July 1964. Passing Volmax and cresting one of the canals that once serviced the many central area factories and warehouses. Scenes now along Ashton New Road. 1313 pulls up at one of the corporation's distinctive stop signs near Main's Depot and the old Carlton Cinema. In Clayton, a 215 purrs towards Audenshaw as a Main's AEC Regent makes for the city. Passing the Snipe Inn on Manchester Road. This Manchester Crossley DD42 was filmed on Ashton Moss, covering for a 216X duty. In the gathering twilight at Lees Square, Ashton. Crossing the Lancashire-Cheshire border in the pleasant surroundings of Stamford Park. Descending the steep hill on Rasbottom Street on the approach to Staley Bridge. As in Manchester and Ashton, the terminus consisted of a one-way loop. After the 27th of August 1966, operations were further reduced, with trolleybuses only working during Mondays to Fridays. On the section from Staley Bridge to Audenshaw, it was still possible to see red and blue trolleys working in tandem. There now follows a geographical run from Staley Bridge to Manchester. As far as Audenshaw, the wires were shared by the 216, solely worked by Manchester, and the 218, now solely worked by Ashton, turning to pass slowly under the bridge at the foot of Rasbottom Street. Climbing out of Staley Bridge towards the boundary posts at Stamford Park. various views on the one-way wiring in the centre of Ashton. Note the SHMD van in the foreground of the next shot. Another view of the imposing Market Hall clock tower. Approaching the redesigned layout at Chester Square. Now under Manchester Wires, this inbound 218 heads for the major junction at Audenshaw, from where it will travel into town along the Old Road. An outbound 218 swings onto the complex loop at Audenshaw with its maze of automatic frogs and illuminated signals telling drivers which way the frogs were set. This was terminus for the 215s. Crews were given 24 minutes to make the 5-mile trip back to Stevenson Square. Since May 1966, this had been the closest spot to the centre of Manchester where both operators could still be seen together. The layout allowed through vehicles to pass those parked on the siding. Nicely filled with lady shoppers, a 216 is followed towards the city by an empty 215. However, this would rapidly fill up, giving the conductor plenty of work issuing tickets and running up and down the stairs. Passing the former Palace Cinema at Droylsden Council offices. This overexposed but important view shows a conductor punching a time card in the Gledhill Brook clock, used to regulate running times. The bridge in the background carried a railway siding into a nearby factory, overlooked by Bradford Colliery. A highly evocative scene of a lost age, reflecting the city's industrial heritage. approaching the terminus at Stevenson Square with an Oldham bus on the left. A 2:15 leaves the terminus and turns onto the one-way wiring along Oldham Street. During the final day of public service, a few heads were turned when Rotherham 44 made a test run from Hyde Road Depot through to Staley Bridge. To everyone's surprise, the corporation had agreed that two final tours could take place on the 31st, one involving Rotherham 44 and the other Manchester 1344. Departing Ashton Market, with the replacement Atlantean in pursuit. Perhaps a few folk may even have mistaken 44 for a new Ashton six-wheel trolleybus. Amongst the mills and chimneys on the descent into Staley Bridge. Daimler 44 had started life as a single-decker, being rebodied by Rotherham in 1956. This was the first time a six-wheeler had been seen for over 3.5 years. To provide extra capacity on the very last trip to Staley Bridge at 10:27 p.m, 83 duplicated number 87, Ashton's official last trolleybus. This vehicle had already been sold to the Northern Trolleybus Society. 1354 was the last service trolleybus along the new road. Duplicated by 1321, it ran from the city to Audenshaw and back to Hyde Road Depot. However, it was left to 1302 to become the very last service trolleybus when it unexpectedly worked the 218X departure from Piccadilly to Audenshaw via Ashton Old Road at 10:50 p.m. on the 30th of December 1966. There had been no organised farewell, no special tickets, no commemorative brochure. No one in senior management had seemed remotely interested. Perhaps lurking somewhere was the ghost of Stuart Pilcher, smiling as the trolleybuses he fought so hard to keep off the streets slipped quietly away. On New Year's Eve 1966, scores of enthusiasts took part in the two final tours. That on Rotherham 44 was organised by the National Trolleybus Association, and that on 1344 by the Northern Trolleybus Society. In the best tradition of all memorable tours, these covered as much wiring as possible. Here, Rotherham 44 runs round the loop at Edge Lane, Droylesden. Pursuing a replacement Leyland PD2 on the 215 on the one-way section along Every Street. On depot-only wiring at Pinmill Brow and into Ashton Old Road. Skirting the 1964 roundabout on Fairfield Street. emerging from Hyde Road and turning along the depot-only wiring, making for Stevenson Square. XIII-XIV carried suitable commemorative inscriptions. Both together at Stevenson Square. Speeding towards Audenshaw, passing close to the mains bus garage. XIV only went as far as Ryecroft Hall, but 1344 proceeded towards the Snipe Inn, stopping just short in order to make a battery turn into the site of the former reverser at Gainsborough Road. Observing the 5 mile an hour speed limit for the last time as the booms dip under the bridge at Audenshaw. Red and blue inbound for the final time along the old road, nearing Fairfield Road. After the 31st of December, there would definitely be no more trolleys to Piccadilly, although electric traction would resurface in the shape of the Metrolink trams some 25 years later. The tours finally ended at 8 p.m. when both vehicles entered Hyde Road. Today, hardly anything remains of the one-time network. Ashton Depot is still standing, a proud symbol of one-time civic pride, and a keen eye can still spot telltale signs of former occupancy. Although much rebuilt, Hyde Road still functions as a bus garage. On the night of the 31st of December 1966, the very last trolleybuses entered the hallowed portals and passed into the history books. This tape has been made in cooperation with the Greater Manchester Transport Society. Some of the profit generated will go towards the continued upkeep of the museum's 2 trolleybuses, both locally built Crossleys. Ashton 80 became something of a celebrity when it was the very last all-Crossley trolleybus in the country. XII-50 is the only Manchester six-wheeler to survive. There is also an SHMD Tower Wagon, but under different ownership. 2 operable BUTs remain, Ashton 87 and Manchester 1344. These scenes show the latter operating at the East Anglia Transport Museum at Carlton Colville. All the film seen on this tape has been specially assembled to mark the passing of the Ashton and Manchester trolleybuses 40 years ago. Crucially assisted by M.D. Howarth, N.A. Kenworthy, D. Taylor and K. Walker, Peter Thompson has undertaken an enormous amount of work identifying locations and double-checking the commentary. Trams have returned to the streets of Manchester. Now, with increasing concerns over energy supplies, is the time approaching for the trolleybus to once again play its part? Thank you.